going to be talking about church leadership today. So the first thing I want to talk about is just kind of the basics of leadership, is that you need to be poured into in order to pour out into others. And not only are you a leader, but you're a teacher. So if you stop growing today, then you're not going to be able to teach tomorrow. So in order to be shapeable, you need to have an attitude that is humble, teachable, faithful, and available. So just kind of reflect on, like, have I grown in the past month, yesterday, today, or in the past couple of weeks? Philippians 3:13-14, Paul says, "Forgetting what is behind and straining toward what is ahead, I press on towards the goal to win the prize." So he's talking about how he wants to not let his past character influence who he is today and how he is bringing forward the kingdom of God. He's not going to let his past reputation affect who he is today. He's just thinking solely on the character of God and how that influences him. We're going to be going through Luke 2:52 today, which talks about Jesus and how he grew in wisdom, stature, favor in God, and with people. So the first thing we're going to talk about is wisdom, which is our intellectual growth. It's really important that we continue to challenge ourselves to grow and exercise our minds so we continue to pour into others. Psalm talks about how God's word is living water, and in John, Jesus says, "I am the bread of life." So these two things are important in Moses' life, as we see he goes up to Mount Sinai and spends this intimate time with the Lord, talking with him, growing and learning. And he comes down and his face is literally shining with the glory of God. We want our wisdom and our knowledge to shine on others and to pour into them. And the only way to do that is to continue to grow in that intimate time with the Lord. Not only should you be growing in the Word of God and learning more about the Word of God, but you should also be surrounding yourselves with mentors and people who can help you grow. When you're spending time with somebody who knows more than you, ask them questions. Don't spend your whole time talking about yourself. You should be asking them questions and letting them do the talking. The next thing we're going to talk about is stature. This is kind of your physical growth. So studies show that physical activity improves your mood and stress. This is important because if we're in a good mood and we're not stressed, we're going to be able to talk to people and be more lighthearted and not burden other people with what we're going through. Another thing that you should be thinking about is your thought life. What are you thinking about? Because wherever your thoughts are during the day is kind of what is going to influence who you are and how you pour out into other people. It's important also to make sure that you have a change of pace. Think about how you're spending your days. How much time are you playing, working, spending time with people, or spending alone time? These are four things that if we don't manage them, then somebody else is going to manage them for us, and then we're not going to be able to have a healthy balance of things in our lives. The next thing we're talking about is favor with God. Setting aside time in the morning is super important to have with God's word, prayer, worship, whatever you need that morning. Studies say that setting aside time in the morning is the best time to do this because it's less likely that that time is going to be replaced by seeing a friend or meeting with someone or changing someone's tire, something like that. And also, studies also say that you are more cognitively equipped to do studies in the morning because you're waking up and everything's fresh. The last thing we're talking about is favor with people. This is important because you need to be able to interact with people in order to pour into them, right? So being fruitful, personable, relatable, and authentic. These are four really basic things that we can just practice by being a friend to somebody. Bonhoeffer does a great job at explaining why we as Christians need to have favor with people, and it's that Christians become bearers of burdens, and just as Christ bears our burdens, we're supposed to bear our brothers and sisters' burdens with Christ. And letting somebody else bear your burdens as well is important, because when we allow others to participate in our lives and others allow us to participate in theirs, church and to pour into one another. So remember that the four things are favor with people, favor with the Lord, your stature, and your wisdom. Growing in those four things are going to help you become a better leader in the church. Thanks for listening.